Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to this faculty development program on ICT tools. In today's session, we are going to learn about Edmodo, which is a fast-growing learning management system. So let me demonstrate you over here. I will share my screen with you. Okay. So go to Google, any browser, type Edmodo, go Edmodo, login. So if you are new to Edmodo, sign up and then login. I'm logging it with my email ID. So this is the home screen of Edmodo. It resembles very similar to Facebook because developers are same. You can see here, this is my profile and these are the class created by me. So let's have a look how to create a class. So for creating a class, go over here, create a class. Creating class is same as Google Classroom. You have to type a name, say calculus. You can describe, select a grade, higher education I am selecting. Subject, you can select as you want. Okay, and then create. So we have created a new class. So this window will appear saying add student. So from here you can add the students. If you are having email IDs, you can type over here and you can invite them. Other ways to add, again, you can share a class code, you can share a PDF file, or again invite by email. Three ways you can add your students. It is just same as Google Classroom. How we added our students. And this is a unique class code for every class. So we'll go to the class and we'll see what things we can do over there. So if I click over here, if I want to post something, I can post over here. If you are having some announcement, you can just type over here and do it. Now you can see here two options, again, create a poll and wellness check. So this poll is very interesting feature, I feel, because many times we will have a dilemma to decide what to do. So you can just have a poll and decide depending on that. For example, suppose whether lockdown should be extended further. You can have opinion of the students. You can create a poll for that. You'll see here options. You can type over options is no. So just like a polling. So anyway, okay. And if I post it, it will ask as a poll, like student get out here. So how many, you can see here percentage of students, how many post voted it for yes and how many voted it for no. Then you can share your material also here just by attaching files. Okay. Otherwise from library also you can add. You can type over here. You can have wellness check also of the students. How you are feeling today. So they will select these options. Okay. So this is how we can share the material with the students. Now we'll go to how to create an assignment. creating an assignment is similar in Google Classroom. And for more, I'm not creating here. For more details, has been given in my presentation, PowerPoint presentation. Okay, you can load existing assignment also. If you are, you might have given assignment in last year. Same assignment you can share with your students or here by just clicking on this option, load existing assignment. So we will go to quiz here because I am emphasizing on quiz because there are some features, interesting features in the quiz which are new over here. So let me show you the how to create a quiz. Create a quiz. So you have to fill the details of the quiz and second is the quiz questions. So in details, you have to give the title, then instructions. Okay, you can see your preview and assign option. So quiz title, you can give anything. Say quiz one. You can give here general instructions, whatever you feel. Okay, and then go to questions, design questions. Now you can see here, there are five types of questions, different variety of questions we can prepare. See true or false, multiple choice, short answer, fill in the blanks, matching, and multi-correct answers also. So this is the new feature added to Edmodo. We have seen in Google Forms also we can create a quiz, but in that only two options will be there, like short answer or multiple choice. There true or false we have to create it, fill in the blanks we cannot give it there, matching also not there, and multi-correct answer means here one advantage of Edmodo is we can select our correct answer here itself. We have to just see here multiple choice. If we type some question over here and its responses we have to type over here, then just by checking that box we have to select the correct answer, whereas in Google quiz we have to type first questions and then separately we have to go for answer keys. So already I have prepared one quiz, so I will show you that one. Once you have prepared this quiz, you can just go to assign. Okay, in assign also there we are not yet prepared, so okay, we'll go to the earlier prepared quiz. So for loading earlier prepared quiz, go to library, select from library. You can select from assignment also, you can select from here, quizzes also you can select from here. So let me select this current affairs. So here are two options, edit and assign, because it this has been already prepared. So it is saying here edit option. So let me edit it. Okay, I will go to quiz questions. Okay. So already prepared questions. So I will just show you different variety of questions, how to do it. Go to first question. See, this is a multiple choice question. Suppose my question is this, first university who has started COVID-19 testing lab. And let's type responses like answer, what do you say, options like this, and just by clicking over here you have to, this is the state university, just by clicking over like this you can select the correct answer. Okay, and add here you can add more responses also, say Gondwana University. I can add more responses also here. Here I can duplicate this question also, delete this question also. Okay. Then we'll go to true or false. True or false, it will look like this. You have to type your question here and responses will be automatic, either true or false. Just you have to select the correct answer. And marks you can prescribe over here. Then this is fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. For fill in the blanks, you have to use underscore. Underscore. Wherever you will specify underscore, that will be treated as a blank. For example, here see the sequence. Write the number in the sequence 2, 4, 8, 16. Next is blank, 64. Next is blank. How many blanks you will give? That many. You can give as you want. That many blanks you can give here. And 1 point will be per correct answer. If they write one correct answer, they will get 1 mark. If students correctly write all the correctly fill the blanks, then they will get all the correct all the points. So in this way, we can have partial credit also. Let me add again one more blank set. Comma, if I underscore. This. Okay. So next one is matching. This is again interesting feature. Many times we have to give the questions of this type, matching type. So left hand side you can give and right hand side you can give here correct answer. You have to type here correct answers. It will while it shown to the students, it will automatically shuffle these responses here. And if you want to give more options, you can select over here. For example, suppose I have created one question, find the correct combination for short keys. Okay, so Control C is for copy, Control V for paste, Control X for cut. But if I want more confusion, then I can select all also, I can keep, delete also I can keep. And we will see in preview how it looks like. Okay. And you can give again marking over here. Per correct answer, you will have grading here. The next one is multi-correct answer. In multi-correct answer also, we can easily choose how many correct answers are here. See here, I have prepared one question. Which of the following are Google tools? So I have given here different options: Edmodo, Classroom, Google Forms, Telegram. You can add again more responses over here. So here, Classroom and Google Forms are correct answers. So I have selected this. If only one correct answer, you can just select over here. If two are there, you can select. If all are there, just you can select all. Okay. So here are two correct answers. So I am selecting this. And again, you can add a new question. So these five types of five variety of questions will be there in Edmodo while taking a quiz. Whereas in Google Forms, we cannot have this many choices. So conducting quizzes is far better with the help of Edmodo. So let me show you preview. So once we have filled all the details and we have prepared the question, before assigning, go to preview, how it will look. Let me go to preview. Okay, some preview. Okay, yeah, so already I have specified the time, so countdown has been started. Yeah, it will give the questions. You can see here is our first question. For next, you have to click over here. Next is my true or false question. Another one is fill in the blanks. You can see here to fill in the blanks. Then we have prepared this matching. So additional options we have given here. So you can see they have came in shuffle order. We have to choose like this. Correct answers. Okay. So if you don't want like that, okay. Control C is for copy. Control V is for paste and this is for okay. So like in this way we can match the question. Next, which of the following are Google tools? You can select the correct answers like this. Okay. So this is the preview of our quiz. So everything is, if everything is okay, then we can assign it to the students. Exit it. If something is wrong, you can go again, edit, and then assign it to the students. So if I want to assign it, then assign to students. Okay. Then because I have not selected any class, so it is showing here students. If you are in class and if you have prepared in that class, it will show automatically that class over here. Then we can have due date and time. After that, nobody can submit it. And we can checkbox this. If I want to log this after that due date, then I have to checkbox this. This is the time limit. Like here we can directly specify the time limits. So copying of the questions can be restricted. Suppose if I give 15 questions, then 15 minutes is depends. 15 minutes if I give, then copying will be copying can be restricted. Now you can see different options here: randomized question, add quiz to gradebook, and show results. So this, if I want to shuffle the questions, in shuffle ordering of the questions, I have to checkbox this. I need to checkbox this. And again, I want to add it for a student performance, this quiz, then add to gradebook. Okay, so you have to checkbox this, add to gradebook. And this checkbox you can select if you want your student to see their results after completion. Immediate after completion, they will come to know how many marks they have got. Okay, you can schedule it for later also. Okay, so just let me assign it. Okay, so since we have not selected any class, but you can select the class and you can assign it. Now we'll go quickly to the student's progression. So in classes, you can see here class management, first due, and progress. So if I want to check student's progression, go to the progress of the students. You can see here, if you select the class, this is my earlier class, major and integration, where I have given assignment one, assignment two, and I have conducted one quiz also. So you can see here already, for quiz automatic grading has been done. For assignments, I have not yet graded them, but you can have the marks over here, how many marks you want to give. Suppose for I have assignment for 5 marks, you can after verifying the assignments, you can give the marks over here like this. So you can give the marks and then you can have total grading of the students. Now one of the important feature is, again, you can export this 5 grading marks, grades of the students. This file you can directly export as a CSV file. Yeah, so if I click on export, it will, that CSV file will be created and you can save it to, okay, you can open or you can save it to your desktop. If you want to delete it, you can delete it. That option will be also there. Okay, so this is all about the quizzes. Now, for every teacher, there will be unique profile URL. So let me go over here. Then you can see your profile of the teacher. For every teacher, there will be profile. To see their profiles, there will be unique URL. You can see. So this is my profile. It will show here how many students I have taught. You can say about yourself. You can add your interest. And this will be used for, if you want to share your profile with others, you can just copy this one. That will be your URL. If you share with the, let me copy this. Okay, I will tell you how, where, from where you have to select that URL. In settings, you have to go. Okay, in settings, you can, yeah, this is the profile URL. You can have unique profile URL. This much will be the same for the teachers. And here you can have the changes. You can save that profile URL. Okay. You can, I think option is here. Yeah. Copy option. Copy this URL. And once you copy this, you can share with others. So the, for example, let me show you how it looks like. Anybody who clicks this URL, they will get such a page. So this will be treated as a proof that you are using learning management system and which activities you have did. Okay, so this will be a proof for learning management system. Many times we require, like in NAC also, we have to show the proof of using learning management system. Okay, so this can be done over there. Okay, so this is all about Edmodo. All about Edmodo. Now, everything I have explained over here, I hope you understood how to use Edmodo, how to create a class, how to have an assignments, how to conduct quizzes, how to check the progress of the students over here. And again, one more thing I want to show you. We can analyze the results. Let me show you the earlier assignment. Yeah, so see here, I have given assignment to the students and how many has submitted, like 56 submissions. We can see from here, view assignment. Yeah, here you can see how many students turned in, how many has submitted, how many not submitted. Okay, who has submitted, you can enter grades over here, and whoever not submitted. So okay, whoever not submitted, for these two students have not submitted, so you can request them for resubmission also by checking the boxes. Okay, so you can grade them directly, you can grade them, or if you want to request for resubmission also, you can request them. For example, like this, you can write over here, type over here, and submit the request to the students. That request will go to the student for resubmission. So you can message the students also. Yeah, this all things you can do over Edmodo. So I hope you understood how to create a class and conduct quizzes, conduct assignments. So, Prof, thank you very much.